With the current hype of AI technologies, many developers are worrying, will AI take our jobs? Today, we flip the script and we'll see how we can use AI as our ally, specifically how to use GitHub Copilot as our pair programming buddy. Hi guys, my name is Janne Greis, I hope you're doing well and I welcome you to a new video. Well, in one of my recent videos, we took a look at ChatGPT and saw how we can use it to build a whole app. This time, we will use GitHub Copilot not to build a whole app, but we will see some use cases where it can help us to fasten up the development process. The large language model, or in short LLM, it's built on by OpenAI is called Codex, and it can process natural language and outputs, code essentially. It's a generative AI tool, and at the end it takes your code or the context of your code and finally outputs a suggestion what you could write next. Hereby it not only considers the current cursor position, so the text around that cursor, but also neighbor tabs, for example in your IDE, or of course the file you currently open up. Additionally, there's a false information out there that you have no chance of not training the model with your own code. But as you can see here in the GitHub Copilot settings, there's a checkbox you can opt out, and then your code won't be used for training the model. But before we can start using GitHub Copilot, of course you need to sign up to it. So I'm currently here at GitHub, and as you can see, it's $10 per month. And you can go on a free trial here and start using it. After successfully signing up to GitHub Copilot, additionally, of course, you need to install the actual plugin. The plugin is not only available to Android Studio exclusively, but also to other JetBrains IDEs and also, for example, for Visual Studio Code. There are also some settings you can adapt in the GitHub Copilot settings tab here. So like showing automatically completions, you can turn that off if that annoys you. And it's also possible to colorize your completions, for example. To look at a practical example, we're here back in Android Studio. And if we open up here the project tab, we can see that we have here load nodes use case and it's not filled out. Additionally, we have a mock repository, which is also missing some code. Interface that's supposed to load nodes. And of course, we have here a node DTO and also app model of node. So let's first go to the node repository, and what we want to do is that let's say we want to have the nodes API inside, and as you can see, GitHub Copilot directly proposes me to add an a parameter for the nodes API. So next, what we want to do is that we load from that nodes API. And as you can see, once again, I don't have to do anything. It directly realizes, okay, we have here a nodes API file open, and also we are in the nodes repository. It saw the load nodes use case and directly knows what we might want to do. So in this case, I just had a hit tab and the code is there. Okay, it misses here the return type. So that's what I want to add manually. But as you can see, it's kind of clever and knows the context of our files here, as I mentioned also in the intro. So now that we have that, let's go to the load nodes use case. And here, of course, we now want to access the nodes repository. So we need that in the constructor here. And as you can see, it proposes the nodes API, which is not what we want, but we can now toggle through additional suggestions. At this point, it says no more Copilot suggestions available. So now I have to manually use the nodes repository. And then here I say, well, and now it realizes, okay, it wants to fetch the node DTOs. So I say tab. And once again, I want to add the types here. And now the next thing I want to do is to map from the nodes DTO to the actual app model. And of course, I would normally use a mapper of some kind, but in this case, GitHub Copilot directly, realizes, okay, it needs to map. It also knows what parameters are inside of each of the classes and proposes me directly this code snippet here. So once again, I hit tab and it perfectly matches. Now we can go one step further and say we also want to load the nodes in our view model. So we go to the here to the home view model, and once again we want to get the loads nodes use case, and this time it matches correctly. I import the use case, and now what we want to have is our home state, which should contain the nodes. And also a function that should load the nodes on, yeah, maybe on the initial initialization of the home view model. And yeah, let's see if that works. So it now directly proposes to create a home state, but that is not in the way we want it, because we want to use a state flow. So we say private val state and use here the mutable state flow, and here it correctly proposes to fill in the home state, and now it also says assign the private state to the public state variable, and here I just add the state flow, and now the next thing is in it. Okay, it already sees that, so we say here load nodes, and then additionally maybe it also realized that. Yeah, it does. Wow. And we hit tab and are essentially done here. So while that was already helpful, even if there are some parts where I had to adapt the code, which GitHub Copilot proposed, let's see how we can use it for creating unit tests. So we're here in a load nodes use case test. And let's see what GitHub Copilot proposed for us. At first, nothing. Perfect. So we need, of course, our use case here. So we say late init loads use case, of course. And then we want to have a setup here. In my base test, there's also a setup method, so it correctly sees what I have here, but it doesn't see that in my base class there is a setup function that is called a little bit different in camel case. So let's adapt that. And also the super call. Now it matches. So what I also need here is a mocked nodes repository. So I say here private val nodes repository equals mock. And then, of course, the class name nodes repository, and now I can actually write my first test. So let's see what it tells us. Okay, that doesn't make sense. Maybe there's also another suggestion. No, it's not. Okay, then let's say add test manually. Now it proposes the first test, and then let's see what it proposes here. Okay, nothing. So we do it once again manually. So let's start with the pattern act arrange assert. Oh, okay. Now it proposes something. I hit tab. Let's see. And yeah. Okay, now, yeah, now it proposed something and it looks okay. I mean, given when then, it's essentially the same. So like the arrange act assert pattern, which I just mentioned. Yeah, let's try out if the test succeeds. And as we can see, the test failed. Why is that? Because we missed the mocking of the repository. So let's say every nodes repository fetch nodes, and import here the every, then we say returns empty list. And now that also is an error, because the repository doesn't return nodes, but a node DTO. And now if we once again run the test, we can see that the test runs successfully. So while that attempt was a little bit bumpy, let's try another one, because GitHub Copilot always needs context to create or propose its code snippets. So here we see it proposes another test, and now it says found course should return list of nodes when nodes repository returns list of node DTOs. And now you can see, because it knows how a test should look like, it can completely come up with the same thing. So let's try out the proposal here. And as you can see, it didn't see that the ID here is of the type string. So let's quickly fix that. And now we can once again run the test here and see it's successfully. So here we really only check if the load nodes use case returns equal list of nodes that we mapped in this use case. So now that we saw how GitHub Copilot can help us to create code and also to create unit tests, let's see a different context. Here we have a JSON file, and let's assume we have to mock some data or something like that. It is also capable to realize how the structure of this JSON looks like. And now we have here a file and a translation that is, of course, here in DE. So in German, das Wetter heute oder ist heute wirklich schön. And of course, we now also need some more translations, not only the German one. And let's see what GitHub Copilot comes up with. And as you can see, it correctly translates. The weather is really nice today. So it can also translate text, which is really interesting. So also in France. And I could go further, probably Spanish and so on. And just to showcase that is also really interesting. So as a last showcase, let's see how we can maybe create a screen. So we create, create node, because in every nodes app, you also want to create some nodes. And we say create node screen as the file name. And here we now start by saying composable fun create node screen. It also works. And here we say we want to have our content, and that looks like that. So now it's added two to-dos, but maybe we can add a comment here. Let's try that out and explain what we want to have in the screen. So as we say, a scaffold which contains a top app bar. Function call to save the node. With that context, let's see if GitHub Copilot can come up with an actual solution, or if we have to do it all by ourselves. I mean, we are at the pair programming session here, so it's not only that GitHub Copilot should code everything, we should still have some things to do. So it doesn't look like it comes up with something, so let's help it a little bit. We say scaffold here, and it only adds to-dos. That's not cool. So let's say here modifier fill max size, and does it realize that? No. Okay, maybe also further to-dos. Maybe it doesn't know JPEG Compose that well, I'm not sure. But we say here, use a column. And here it also proposes to use the modifier for max size. And that is, by the way, also one thing that is a little bit annoying. With the IntelliSense, so the auto suggestion of IntelliJ or Android Studio, there are many times some conflicts, as you just saw, so that IntelliJ wants to propose something and also at the same time GitHub Copilot. And that's also why there is a setting in the GitHub Copilot settings tab where you can turn off the auto suggestion. and only use it on a button click or something like that. So at this point, we want to add the inner padding. And okay, we give it a last chance. Maybe, okay, floating action button to do. I mean, okay, it realizes that we want to have a floating action button. That's okay. But also the wrong imports. I'm currently not quite sure what the correct one is. Fair position and okay. And we also want the top bar. So, okay, it also only adds a to-do. Quite sad. Okay, then we help it a little bit. And you can already see we are inside the brackets. When I now hit tab, it just jumps into the next line and doesn't accept the proposal. So now it works when I go back into it. So now we just want here to opt in and leave the rest out. And yeah, what we now want here is the edit field, but or the text field. Okay, I misspelled it. Sorry, GitHub Copilot. I took the wrong name. But maybe you could figure it out from the context which one is the correct field. Obviously not. No problem. And now we want to connect it to a function here that is not present at the moment. So let's type that in on save note. Okay. What we have next on title change. No, that's not what we need. But we also want to have on value change maybe. And we could also say note input or something like that. So we take that as our value. And here we can say on value change. And yeah. Then we could also put call the screen counter from here. But as you can see, what I want to show you here, that it's not free from problems. And at least here in the Jetpack Compose space, it has some problems. They also know from other projects like Next.js projects or React projects that it sometimes comes up with weird stuff and it's not always really helpful. So as we saw in this video, GitHub Copilot, our new pair programming buddy. I mean, it can be clever and come up with really good solutions or proposals, but as we saw in the last example, sometimes it also really messes up. I for myself use it on a daily basis and I think it can be really helpful. I think GitHub Copilot promotes it with 55% faster development speed. I don't know if that is really the case, but if you have repetitive tasks or patterns you create in your code, it can really facilitate the writing process because it will see, okay, that is a pattern and he will be using it in the next file again or whatever. It can detect the contents of different classes and knows what parameters you want to access and so on. And yeah, that can be helpful, but not in all cases. So at the end, I can only encourage you to try it out for yourself and yeah, get an own opinion about it. Have you maybe already tried it out? Leave a comment and say what's your impression about it. It's definitely not like it's a completely replacement of a developer, but it can be seen as a supporting tool. I mean, that is also what it's meant to be. And there are always these statements, AI will replace you. I think it's not the case, at least with GitHub Copilot. So as always, I hope you had some takeaways. Like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, activate the notification bell, and I hope to see you soon.